6 hours behind. Our semi trailer truck is 120 miles away.
It's 6:40. The stage, you could say, is set.
Anything that could have gone wrong has gone wrong.
You needn't all be stressed.
It's now 7:06 p.m.
We're gonna move fast. We're gonna get this thing going in about 45 minutes to an hour.
Probably do a better job running the world than I do. I just thought I'd remind you, I've been trying to find you. It feel like Satan working overtime, times two. They say if it doesn't kill you, that refines you. But I'm trying to live, and that's bigger than survival. It's been a long night, it's been a long fight. So just remind me now, everything will be alright.
Have a good time. Gonna be up in the air with some God time, and you're good on the genuine. Like illumination, illumination. You light up my life like you lit up creation. Won't let me drown. You
my flotation. Won't let me thirst, cause you my hydration. So I'ma do my dancing rhymes. This love is gonna last, you wrong. You're everything to me, everything I need, everything I wanna be, JC.
You got me like, yeah. Oh.
To the right, praise to the front, praise to behind, praise to the left, praise to the right, praise to the front, praise to behind, praise to the left, praise to the right, praise to the front, praise to behind, praise to the left, praise to the right, praise to the front, praise to behind, praise to the left, to the right, to the front, to behind, to the left, to the right, to the front, to behind.
I will find my way to you. Now I can see clearly, my God, you.
know it's true. Yeah, I know that your love is all around. I believe in you, holding on to you, holding on, and I know you will never fail. I want all of you, you never change your love.
Hi, shalom and good evening to all my brothers, sisters and friends who are watching this recording. I hope all of you are doing well. We know that right now in Malaysia, we're having another round of a full lockdown, and we've been seeing still a high number of cases reported daily, and there's no end in sight. So maybe due to this situation that we're in currently, that you may be feeling a bit anxious, or you have worries and you're unsure about your future or your children's future, may just encourage you today that we have an ultimate hope, which is our Lord Jesus Christ. That no matter what we are going through today, that we have this anchor and know that He is with us and He will never forsake us. So today, let's just spend some time as we worship Him. Just reflect upon His finished work for us on the cross and the love that He has poured out for us. That today, we have this hope and this assurance and this peace in our hearts. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you for all that you have done for us, Lord.
A wreath of thorns became your crown. My curse was laid upon
love.
presence, knowing that you'll never leave me, you'll never forsake me, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the praise you, Lord. Thank you.
大家平安
Shalom everyone.
愿大家在这一段抗疫的日子当中
As now we are in the time of this epidemic prevention,
所发生的一切的事情都引领我们更加来亲近我们的父
神 Everything that has happened is to lead us to our Father.
每一天我们都从不同的管道
Every day from different channel,
我们接收到非常消极或负面的资讯
We receive a lot of negative news.
但是今天我要借着圣餐
But today through the communion,
来提醒我们
I'd like to remind ourselves,
有一位爱我们的天父
There is a Father who loves us so dearly.
所以让我们每一个时刻除了做好防疫措施之外
Except that we have done our best to prevent this epidemic,
我们更加的来信靠我们的父神
Let us come and trust our Father.
信靠这一位非常的爱我们的
To trust this one who loves us so dearly.
因为我们是他以重价救赎回来的子民
Because we have been paid with great price.
神赐予我们不变的这个平安
God has given us this unchanging peace.
现在就让我们一起来祷告。
So let us pray.
父神，我们献上我们的感恩。
Father, we give thanks to you.
你是如此的爱我们。
You love us so dearly.
纵使我们看见每一天报告这对于疫情并没有一个非常好的消息。
Although there is not much good news about the report of this pandemic,
但是我们在做好我们自己的一个应当所做的措施当中之外
But apart that we have done our best,
我们更加的来信靠你
Yes, we want to come and trust in you.
因为你爱我们
Because you love us.
我们是你拣选的子民
We are the chosen people by you.
你有一个重任要交给我们
And you have a mission that has been given to us.
所以让我们时刻的以你为我们生活的中心
And let us be able to put you in the center of our lives
而不是让这些的消息来打击我们
And not allowing all this news to come and defeat us
我们谢谢你赐予我们的平安
We thank you for giving us this peace
我们感恩奉耶稣的名我们祷告
In Jesus name we pray
Amen
Amen
让我们一起的来领这个圣餐
So let us partake the communion together. If there is anyone next to you,
告诉他
tell him or her,
我们的父神非常的爱你
Our Heavenly Father loves you so dearly.
今天我要和大家来分享一个小故事
Today I would like to share with you a small story.
有三个人
There were three persons.
他们的名字是
And their names are
真理
The truth
信心
The faith
感觉
And the feeling.
今天他们要走过一条的独木桥
And today they're going to cross through a single log bridge.
感觉说我来带头
Then the feeling said that, come, let me lead you.
可是当他走到这个桥的一半的时候
But while he was halfway of the bridge,
这个感觉开始感觉到他不能够走完这条桥。
And this the feeling feel that he can't finish crossing the bridge.
所以他就拉着信心一起的倒下去了。
So he just grab faith and then they all fall.
那个时候呢，真理看见他们这样。
So when the truth saw them,
真理就把信心和感觉扶起来。
And then the truth just take the help the faith and the feelings up.
然后就一步一步的带领他们走完这整条的独木桥。
And he take us step by step crossing over the bridge.
在我们的生活中
，In our lives,
当我们面对挑战的时候
，When we are facing challenges,
我们是否也曾经让感觉来做带头的工作
？Have we ever also allowing the feeling to lead us?
但是事实的告诉我们
，But the reality tell us.
唯有让真理来做带领才是最佳的选择。
The best choice is allowing the truth to lead us.
所以弟兄姐妹们
So brothers and sisters,
让我们在生活里面我们要去体验神的这个的真理。
So let us be able to experience the truth in our lives.
在这个金钱的一个使用和管理上。
And also in managing our finance.
神在马拉基书三章十节上说
God said in the book of Malachi 3:10
你们要把当纳的十分之一归入在神的家中
So bring all the tithes into the storehouse
使得神的家里面充足有粮
So that there is enough food in God's storehouse
以此来试试看神是否把天窗打开
Test me and see whether I will open the gates of heaven
倾倒所有的祝福在我们的身上
And pour down all the blessings unto you
一直到充足有余
Until there is enough
所以这个时候让我们预备我们的心
So let us prepare our hearts
一起来祷告
So let us pray
来预备好我们要奉献给神的家中
So as we prepare ourselves to give to the house of God
来领受神的祝福
And to receive his blessing
让我们一起来祷告
So let us pray
天父我们献上我们的感恩
Father we give you thanks
我们知道我们所拥有的一切都是属于你的
We believe that everything that we own is belong to you.
今天我们把当纳的十分之一归入在神你的家中。
And today we put all these tithes into your storehouse.
以此我们能够来经历神你满满的祝福。
So that we'll be able to experience of the abundant blessing.
我们要献上我们的感恩。
We want to give you thanks.
我们的感谢祈求祷告是奉耶稣的名求的。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
弟兄姐妹们
Brothers and sisters.
这个时刻就让我们预备好我们的心来奉献给神的教会
Come on, let us prepare our hearts and give to the house of God.
弟兄姐妹们大家好
Good day, brothers and sisters.
欢迎大家再次来参与我们的线上崇拜
Welcome once again to join our online service.
那今天我们要从大家都非常熟悉的一段经文来学习。
Today we're going to start with a passage that we're very familiar with.
这段经文就算非信徒可能都会知道里面的其中一节经文。
So this familiar is so familiar to this passage is so familiar to most of us that even some non-believers might know one of the scripture in there.
我想现在你应该可以猜到了，那就是约翰福音第三章。
I believe you guess it now, which is John chapter 3.
我们今天要看的这段经文是耶稣与这个尼哥德慕的一段对话。
So the passage we're going to look at today is Jesus' conversation with Nicodemus.
尼哥德慕是新译本的翻译。
Nicodemus is actually the translation in the new NIV.
Okay, 这个是中文
okay,
跟英文没有关系
okay,
然后在和合本里面翻译成尼哥底母
okay, There's a difference between a new and previous version of translation for the Mandarin
yep, 所以我在讲这一篇信息的时候我会用新译本的翻译 okay, 然后这整段的对话呢是从第一节到第二十一节
So this whole conversation starts from chapter verse 1 to verse 21
但是时间的关系我只会读到第十八节而已
Because of time constraint, I will only be talking until verse 18
okay, 约翰福音第三章第一到第十八节有一个法利赛人名叫尼哥德慕是犹太人的官长
John 3, 1 to 18 Now there was a Pharisee, a name named Nicodemus, who was a member of the Jewish ruling council.
他夜间来到耶稣那里，对他说：“拉比。” 我们知道你是从神那里来的教师，因为如果没有神同在，你所行的这些神迹就没有人能行。He
came to Jesus at night and said, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one could perform the signs you are doing if God were not with him.
耶稣回答，我实实在在告诉你，人若不重生，就不能见神的国。Jesus
replied, Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God unless they are born again.
尼哥德慕说， 人老了怎能重生呢? 难道他能再进母腹生出来吗?
How can someone be born when they are old? Nicodemus asked. Surely they cannot enter a second time into their mother's womb to be born.
耶稣回答， 我实实在在告诉你， 人若不是从水和圣灵生的， 就不能进神的国。
Jesus answered, Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born of the water and the spirit.
从肉身生的就是肉身，从灵生的就是灵。你不要因为我对你说，你们必须重生而感到稀奇。Flesh
gives birth to flesh, but the spirit gives birth to spirit. You should not be surprised at my saying you must be born again.
风随意而吹，你听见它的响声，却不知道它从哪里来，往哪里去。凡从圣灵生的也是这样。
The wind blows wherever it pleases. You hear its sound, but you cannot tell where it comes from or where it's going. So it is with everyone born of the Spirit.
尼哥德慕说：“怎能有这事呢？”
How can this be? Nicodemus asked.
耶稣说：“你是以色列人的教师，还不明白这事吗？ 我实实在在告诉你，我们知道的才讲论，见过的就作证。然而你们却不接受我们的见证。” 我对你们讲地上的事，你们尚且不信，如果讲天上的事，怎能相信呢？
You are Israel's teacher, said Jesus, and you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what you know, and we testify to what we have seen. But still, you people do not accept our testimony. I have spoken to you of earthly things, and you did not believe. How then will you believe if I speak of heavenly things?
除了那从天上降下来的人子，没有人升过天。 摩西在旷野怎样把铜蛇举起，人子也必照样被举起来，使所有信他的人都得永生。No
one has ever gone into heaven except the one who came from heaven, the Son of Man. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes may have eternal life in him.
神爱世人，甚至把他的独生子赐给他们，叫一切信他的，不至灭亡，反得永生。因为神差他的儿子到世上来，不是要定世人的罪，而是要使世人借着他得救。信他的不被定罪，不信的罪已经定了，因为他不信神独生子的名。
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already because they have not believed in the name of God, the one and only Son.
为了要帮助大家更深入地了解这一段经文的背景,
So in order to help you understand the background of this scripture,
在读完这段经文过后, 我们会播一段的影片。
So after reading this scripture, we'll be showing a short clip.
然后这一段影片是从最近非常火红的一部福音电视剧《The Chosen》里面剪出来的。
So this is a clip from a very popular gospel theme series on TV recently, which is called The Chosen.
然后据我的观察，这影片里面大部分的对白跟情节都跟这一段我们刚才读的经文是吻合的。
So from my observation, I've seen that the most of the conversation and the plot is quite close to original scripture.
所以现在就让我们一起来欣赏吧。
So now have a look at this short video clip.
Thank you for agreeing to meet. Thank you for trying to help Mary when you did. It was no help.
You were meant to be there.
Me? So I could fail miserably? At an exorcism in the Red Quarter?
If you had not been there that day, would you be on this roof tonight?
I don't know where to start. I have so many questions.
Shall we sit first?
Oh, yes, of course. The eastern slums.
Hmm.
Many wandering preachers have succeeded in gathering crowds with their rhetoric and fiery tone.
I've heard a few of them over the years myself.
So you know the type. Mm-hmm. But I have never heard anyone tell a paralytic to get up and walk, much less it actually happened.
So what is your conclusion?
I believe you are not acting alone. No one can do these signs you do without having God in him. Only someone who has come from God.
And how is that belief going over in the synagogue? Which is why we are here at this hour. What else?
What have you come here to show us?
A kingdom.
That is what our rulers are worried about.
No, not that kind.
Then what?
A sort of kingdom that a person cannot see unless he is born again.
Born again?
Yes.
You mean like a new creature? A conversion from Gentile to Jewish?
No, no, that's not what I'm talking about.
Then what is born again? I hope you don't mean return to the womb, because that would be a problem for me. My mother, may she rest in peace, is dead.
Truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. That part of you, that is what must be reborn to new life.
How can these things be?
Ah, a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things, huh?
I'm trying, Rabbi.
I know. I know. Do you hear this?
What?
Listen. What do you hear?
The wind?
How do you know it's the wind?
Because I can feel it. I hear its sound.
Do you know where it comes from?
No.
Do you know where it's going?
No.
That's what it is to be born again of the Spirit. The Spirit may work in a way that is a mystery to you. And while you cannot see the Spirit, you can recognize his effect.
Mind is consumed with thoughts of what a stir these words would cause among the teachers of the law.
Yes, and I do not expect otherwise. I speak of what I know and have seen, and it has not been received by the religious leaders.
It is hard to receive.
So if I have told you of earthly things, and you do not believe, how can I tell you heavenly things?
I believe your words. I just fear you may not have a chance to speak many more of them before you are silenced.
I have come to do more than speak words, Nicodemus.
More miracles?
Yes. But even more than that. Do you remember when the children of Israel complained against God and against Moses in the wilderness of Paran?
Yes. They wanted to return to Egypt, and they cursed the manna that God sent them.
And then?
They were bitten by serpents. And they were dying. But God made a way for them to be healed.
Moses lifted the bronze serpent in the desert, and people only needed to look at it. So will the Son of Man be lifted up, so that whoever believes in him may have eternal life.
Our people are not dying from snake bites. They're dying from taxation and oppression.
I'm sorry to disappoint you. But I did not come to deliver the people from Rome.
Then from what?
From sin. From spiritual death. God loves the world in this way, that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
So this has nothing to do with Rome. It's all about sin.
God did not send his son into the world to condemn it, Nicodemus. He sent him to save it through him. It's as simple as Moses' serpent on the pole. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already.
Have you ever heard anything like this before?
Shh. When I met Lilith, Mary, that day, I told my wife and my students, I said, she was beyond human aid. Only God could have healed her. And then I saw her healed. And here you are. The healer. My whole life I have wondered if I would see this day.
Follow me, and you'll see more.
Follow you?
Join me and my students. In 2 days' time, we leave Capernaum. Come see the kingdom I am bringing into this world.
But I can't.
You have a position in the Sanhedrin. You have family. You are getting advanced in years. I understand. But the invitation is still open.
The invitation to what exactly? To lead a nomadic life? To give up who I am?
It's true. There is a lot you would give up. But what you would gain is far greater and more lasting.
Is this another one of your born-again mysteries?
Maybe. I know mysteries aren't easy for a scholar. Think about it. Take your time. On the morning of the fifth day, we leave, and we'll meet by the well in the southern quarter at dawn.
Is the kingdom of God really coming?
What does your heart tell you?
My heart is swollen with fear and wonder. It can tell me nothing except that I am standing on holy ground.
I do hope you come with us, Nicodemus. You don't have to do that. What are you doing?
Kiss the sun, lest he be angry and you perish in the way.
Blessed are all who take refuge in him.
Okay. 这段影片我看了之后，它给我很深的感动。
So I was very touched after watching this video.
所以我希望它也能够祝福到你。So
I hope this can also be a blessing to you.
现在我就要跟大家来分享三个我从当中学习到的原则。So
now I'm going to share the three principles that I've captured from watching this part.
那我把这篇信息放下这个主题叫做天国初体验。
So I titled this sermon as The First Taste of the Kingdom.
哦，第一点就是，我们所面对的挣扎往往是一场属天相遇的开始。
So the first point is the struggles we face is often the beginning of a divine encounter.
而在第一到第二节这边。
So from verse 1 to verse 2,
这边就提到说，这个法利赛人的官长尼哥德慕去见耶稣。
Here it mentions a Pharisee named Nicodemus who from the Jewish ruling council came to Jesus.
然后我先解释一下这段经文的背景。
So let me start by explaining the background of the scripture.
这个尼哥德慕是谁呢？
Who is Nicodemus?
他是一位非常熟悉圣经、旧约圣经的法利赛人。
So he is a person that's very familiar with the Old Testament of the Bible. He's a Pharisee.
哦，不单是这样哦，他也是一位很具有影响力的法利赛人的领袖。
So not only that, he is also an influential Jewish leader.
哦，简单来说就是他是一位有知识然后有地位的法利赛人。
So put it simply, he's someone that's knowledgeable and also someone in high position.
然后这边有一个疑问，就是为什么他会选择在夜间在晚上去见耶稣呢？
So the strange thing here is, why did he choose to go meet Jesus at night?
原因很简单。
So the reason was very simple.
因为在那个时候，耶稣他是一位非常具争议性的人物。
Because at that time, Jesus was a controversial figure.
为什么？因为他的所作所为，因为他的教导非常的跟当时的普遍接受的一些做法跟教导有很大的出入。
Why? Because what Jesus did and so what he taught was very much different from what was acceptable to the people at that time.
他在安息日的时候医治人。
He healed people during the Sabbath.
他去到那一些所谓的罪人的地方，跟税吏、跟妓女在一起。
So he went to these so-called sinners to be with them, to be with these tax collectors, to be with these prostitutes.
所以当时的宗教领袖大部分都把他看成是邪教异端的教主。
So most of the leaders at the time saw him as a leader of a cult.
所以你就可以明白为什么尼哥底母他要在晚上的时候才去见耶稣。
Then you understand why Nicodemus only chose to go meet Jesus at night.
你可以想象一下，如果人知道这么一位受人敬重的领袖去见耶稣的话，去见这位邪教教主的话，那肯定是成为头条新闻。
Imagine such a respectable figure going to meet such a controversial cult leader. So what would people react?
然后现在另外一个问题又来了。
So the next question comes.
那是什么原因使到这位有知识、有地位的尼哥德慕愿意冒险去见这一位耶稣呢
？So what caused this knowledgeable, influential figure to take this risk to go and meet Jesus？
圣经在这方面没有清楚的说明。
So this was not noted in the Bible。
但是在电视剧里面，如果你有看的话，这一个墓之前的一些你就会看到这个电视剧里面给了一个可能的答案。
So if you saw the video that we showed just now, it gave a possible reason for that。
那就是有这样一幕，就是尼哥德慕他要尝试把鬼从那个莫大拉的玛利亚身上赶出来，但是他失败了。
There was a scene where Nicodemus tried to cast out the demon from Mary Magdalene, but he failed.
当然没有人能够确定这个东西是否真的有发生。
Of course, no one can really tell whether this actually happened or not.
所以但是重点是在于，虽然我们不知道尼哥德慕到底经历了什么。
So the main thing is, even though we don't know what Nicodemus experienced,
使到他会这么迫切要去见耶稣。
That caused him to be so desperate in meeting Jesus.
但是我们可以确定的一点是，
One thing you can be sure of,
尼哥德慕肯定是经历了一段的内心的挣扎。
Nicodemus surely has struggled internally for some time before taking this action.
这种挣扎让他寝食难安，所以他一直都在想。
This struggle caused him to be restless, so he keep thinking about that.
所以一直在想，为什么我们如此熟悉律法，却没有办法把医治带给病人？
He was struggling with why we who are so familiar with the law. So hard, we are not able to bring the healing to the sea.
然后为什么我们如此的遵守这些律法，却没有办法把鬼从这些人身上赶出来？
Why we who are so observant of the law not able to cast out demons from the people?
然后为什么我们这么努力的教导人要遵守律法，然后也示范要怎样遵守律法，却无法使人能够不去做犯罪的事情？
Why we who are so diligently teaching the law and also by our own example, setting example of observing the law, but yet we could not stop people from committing sin?
Oh, 但是这一个整天跟罪人生活在一起的耶稣却能够使病人得医治。
But yet this Jesus who's always around sinners could heal the sick.
Oh, 使那些被鬼附的得释放。
And cast out demons from people.
这一个耶稣跟其他的异端领袖真的不一样。This
Jesus is indeed different from other cult leaders.
我看到神的同在在他的身上。I
see God's presence on this person.
我想不行，我一定要去见见这一位拿撒勒人耶稣。So
he must be thinking, surely I must go and meet this Nazarite Jesus.
但是如果被人家发现怎么办呢？
But what if I was discovered by others?
所以挣扎了一段时间过后，他最终做了一个决定，晚上去见耶稣。So
after struggling for some time, he made a decision to go find Jesus at night.
所以也因为这样，所以他就经历了这个跟圣子、跟天堂面对面的一个相遇。And
because of that, he had an encounter with the Holy, the Son of God. The encounter with heaven.
所以在电视剧里面，当尼哥德慕跟耶稣提到自己赶鬼失败，败到一塌糊涂的时候
，So when Nicodemus in the TV series when Nicodemus shared his failure in casting out demon with Jesus，
耶稣这样子回答他
，Jesus answered him in this way，
耶稣回答说：“你如果没有经历那个失败，你今天晚上会出现在这里吗？”
He asked, if you had not been there that day, would you be on this roof tonight?
这不是印证了这一点，我们面对的挣扎往往是一场属天相遇的开始吗？
Doesn't this confirm show us that the struggles we face are often beginning of divine encounter?
所以回到新山希望教会。
So coming back to Hope JB.
我们，尤其是我们的领袖们。
Us, for us, especially our leaders.
又何尝不是经历了一段挣扎、寻求的时间过后，才开始了这一段天国之旅吗？
Didn't we go through a long process of struggle and seeking before we start on this kingdom journey?
我还记得光义牧师跟我们分享过。
I remember Pastor Kwong Lee sharing with us before.
所以在带领新山希望教会多年之后。
Many years after leading Hope JB.
所以他感觉到我们来到了一个瓶颈。
He felt that we have come to a bottleneck.
所以他感觉到新山希望教会离他所相信，就圣经所描述的那个教会，好像越来越远了。
He felt that it's Hope JB seems getting further and further away from the Bible that's mentioned in the Bible.
这使他开始进入所谓的那种挣扎期里面。
So the church that's mentioned in the Bible. Therefore, he came to the period of struggle.
然后要开始祷告，开始寻求神。So
he started to pray, started to seek God.
甚至他开始挑战自己，去报名参与一些他以前不会去参与的一些特会、一些训练。So
he even challenged himself to go join some of the training, some of the conferences that previously he would not join.
结果我们看到之后的情况是，像我们华人常说的“老天有眼”。So
indeed, Perhaps God has seen his struggle.
Not God has eyes. Okay, so 一系列的特会让他跟塞敏牧师，就他们在这个这些特会、这些训练当中认识了一些的领袖。
So from through these trainings, through these conferences, he and Pastor Swimin met some of these leaders.
比如说 Paul 牧师, Tim 牧师, Jeff Yun 牧师.
Pastor Paul, Pastor Tim, Pastor Jeff.
这一些在我们之前很多年前就已经开始了这个天国旅程的这些领袖。
These leaders have already embarked on the kingdom journey many years ago.
他们中这些前辈领受分赐。
He received this impartation from these leaders.
并且邀请他们来到我们的营会，来到我们的圣经研习会当中来分享。
And he wanted them to come to our camps, to our Bible conference to share.
这就使到我们当中很多的弟兄姐妹也尝到了与神相遇的那个滋味。
So because of this, many of our brothers and sisters tasted the encounter with God.
改变了我们对自己、对教会、对彼此、对工作、对家庭、对服事的观点。
It changed our perspective towards ourselves, the church, towards each other, to our jobs, towards our family, and also towards our ministry.
所以我自己就是其中一位受益者。
Myself personally is also one of the benefactors.
从这边你可以看到，面对挣扎不一定是坏事。
From here we can see that facing struggles is not surely a bad thing.
面对挣扎使我们开始去重新审查我们的心态。
So as we face struggles, it helps us to once again check our heart attitude.
然后让我们开始重新去审查我们的观点。
Once again, it helps us to re-evaluate our perspective.
我们开始承认自己没有答案。
We start to acknowledge that indeed we don't have the answers.
我们开始谦卑。
We start to be humble.
我们开始祈求神介入来帮助我们，来带领我们。
And ask God to come and intervene and help us.
所以这使我们有一颗更加敞开的心。
This helps us to come with an open heart.
那使我们更加容易察觉到神的作为。
And makes us more perceptible to God's work.
然后这就为我们开了一扇门，让我们能够遇见神。
And opens the door for us to encounter God.
在雅各书第四章第六节，这里就有说，神抵挡骄傲的人，赐恩给谦卑的人。
James 4:6 says God opposes the proud but shows favor to the humble.
所以，当我们谦卑我们自己来到神面前的时候，神必定带领我们。
So when we humble ourselves before God to come before Him, surely He will lead us.
所以，同样的原则也适用于我们的日常生活。
The same principles can be also applied to our daily life.
所以，让我们改变自己来看待问题的观点。
Let us change our perspective on how we see things.
问题不只是问题需要被解决。
The problems are not just things that need to be solved.
问题往往是下一个与神相遇的开始。
Problems are often chance that opens up encounters with God.
让我们在过程当中。 学习安息，然后从当中去，不是专注于要解决那个问题，但是专注让神来带领我们的时候，我们会看到，下一个相遇就在等着我们。So
let us not be just focused on the problem, but let us wait for opportunities to encounter God through these problems.
Amen. 第二点。
Second point.
我们无法全然明白神的作为，但却能够感受到神作为的结果。We
are not able to fully understand the works of God, but we can recognize their effects.
第三到第二十一节，这边就记录了耶稣跟尼哥德慕之间的对话。So
verse 3 to verse 25 talks about the conversation between Jesus and Nicodemus.
耶稣就提到关于重生，关于他要怎样拯救世人。
Jesus mentioned about born again and how he intends to save the world.
So, 耶稣分享了这一切，连尼哥德慕一个这么有知识、对旧约圣经如此熟悉的一个学者都没有办法明白。The
thing Jesus said that even someone that's so knowledgeable of the Bible, knowledgeable towards God, towards the law, could say, "How can these things be?"
他的反应是，怎能有这事呢？
So that. Was the only way he could respond. How can these things be?
我们不能怪他。
But we cannot blame him.
因为换作是我们的话，如果我们活在那个时代。
But even for us, if we were living in that generation.
听到耶稣这样说，我们也应该八成我们也明白不过来。
So when we hear Jesus say this, mostly is we were not able to comprehend that.
想一想，尼哥德慕过去的几十年来都在相信。 要遇见神的国，要进神的国，就要遵守律法。
So think about this. For the past tens of years, Nicodemus always believed In order to enter God's kingdom, he has to observe God's laws.
现在耶稣却告诉他, 要重生才能见神的国。
But now Jesus is telling him, in order to enter God's kingdom, you have to be born again.
要像当年以色列民凭着信心望着摩西的铜蛇一样，相信耶稣才能够得救。
In order to do that, he has to have the faith like the Israelite in the past, where they saw the bronze snake and in the same that Moses lifted up. In the same way, he has to believe in Jesus.
更够力的是,
and the even stronger thing is,
这个得救的过程又没有很清楚的解释，又没有很清楚的步骤。
This path to salvation, there was no clear explanation for it. There's no clear steps for it.
所以难怪尼哥德慕说，怎能如此呢？
So therefore, Nicodemus can only say, how can these things be?
回到我们。 开始了天国旅程过后，我们其实也在面对同样的挑战。
So turning back to us, when we just started this kingdom journey, we also faced these same challenges.
Yeah, not during the just started time. Even now, 就算现在我们也还在有面对很多的所谓的挑战。
Even the whole throughout the whole process, we are always facing challenges.
一些教导看似很简单，但却又如此的复杂。
Some of the teaching seems so simple, but at the same time, it's so complicated.
那比如说,
for example,
什么叫做在天国里一切都是领受的，不是努力赚取的？
What means by saying in the kingdom things are received, not achieved?
Everything
is received, not achieved.
那可能有人问，那我是不是每天坐在家里面 soaking 就行了呢？
So some people are asking, is it just enough for me to soak every day at home? That's all.
然后什么叫做我在天国里的身份不受我的表现的影响？
So what does it mean when we say my identity in the kingdom is not affected by my performance?
Okay, 那我不是就可以享受犯罪的生活，然后还是可以期待死后进天堂？
So doesn't that mean that I can just live my sinful life every day happily, then enter the heaven when I die?
然后什么叫做连结比共识更重要？
So what does it mean when we say connection is more important than agreement?
如果是这样的话，那教会不是没有标准、没有方向了吗？
If we do that, doesn't that mean that there's no standards in the church, there's no direction?
所以有一些问题问出来，我们可能都没有一个完美的答案。
So for some of these questions, we might not have a perfect answer for that.
有些我们所相信的事情会怎样发生，我们可能也没有办法解释的清楚。
Some of things that we believe, how we come to pass, we might not even have a clear explanation of it.
纵然情况是这样,
even though this is a situation,
但我们却见证了许多美好的事情的发生，还有许多的改变。
But yet we have already testified many wonderful things happen and a lot of changes.
比如说我们过往对服事、对教会所存有的那种压力消失了。
For example, the pressure that came from our ministry in the church, it is gone now.
领袖跟领袖之间，领袖跟会员之间那种配搭的时候，产生那种张力、那种压迫感，减低了很多。
The pressures we have within leaders and so between leaders and members are no longer there.
我们也见证到更多的医治，更多神超自然的一些作为。
So we also testify of many healings and so many supernatural work of God.
这就好像是耶稣告诉尼哥德慕的。
So this is just like what Jesus mentioned to Nicodemus.
他说，风随意而吹，你听见它的响声，却不知道它从哪里来，往哪里去。从圣灵生的，就是也是这样。
The wind comes as it does. No one has seen it, but no one understands these things. But yeah, so is the way with the kingdom of heaven.
圣灵使人经历重生，那个过程是怎样的？那是一个奥秘。So
how the reborn again works in the kingdom of God is also a mystery.
但是耶稣要尼哥底母专注在当一个人重生之后，他的生命所发生的改变。
But what Jesus wanted Nicodemus to focus on After a person is born again, his life will change.
就你不晓得重生的那个步骤，那个过程是怎样的。
You might not know how born again happens, what the steps to achieve that.
Okay. 但是你知道。
But you know.
神在这个人的生命当中动了善工。
God is working in this person's life.
因为你看到他的生命改变。
Because you see this person's life changing.
所以同样的，我们虽然不晓得神的良善，神的恩典如何让一个人自愿去选择爱神。
Same thing, we might not understand how God's goodness and His grace causes someone to voluntarily to love God.
我们虽然不晓得神的恩典怎样使一个人自愿选择不去犯罪。
We do not understand how God's goodness causes someone to voluntarily not to commit sin.
Okay, 我们虽然不了解操练尊荣文化如何能够让教会达到合一。
We might not understand how practicing a culture of honor can help the church to come into one unity.
但我们的确看到。
But indeed we see.
也经历到神的良善还有神的恩典的结果。
And experience the fruits that come from God's goodness and His grace.
然后我们也开始尝到操练尊荣文化的甘甜。
We also can start to taste the sweetness of practicing the culture of honor.
然后，《The Chosen》这一部电视剧里面有另外一幕。
Oh, there was also another scene in this TV series, The Chosen.
啊，你有兴趣的话，你可以去看。圣经里面没有这一幕。圣经里面没有记载。
So this scene was not recorded in the Bible.
Okay, 圣经没有这样的记录。Okay, 所以应该可能是他们制作出来的。
So this is not something that from the Bible, so they just produce it for the plot.
Okay, 但是我觉得它蛮值得我们去思考的。
But I believe this is something that's worthy of us for us to consider.
这一幕是尼哥德慕跟他的一位学生在对话。
This was a conversation between Nicodemus and his student.
那位学生说，耶稣的所作所为跟他的教导不符合我们法利赛人对旧约经文的解释。
The things Jesus do and his teachings are not different from how the Pharisees interpret the Old Testament.
他这样做是亵渎神。
What he's doing is blaspheming against God.
尼哥德慕就这样回答他。
So this is how Nicodemus answered him.
啊，这样这个答案很值得我们去思考。
This is.His answer was something is something for us to ponder.
他说，当我们看到神做了一些我们觉得不符合经文的事情，我们会叫神回到我们为他设定的那个框框里面，还是我们会检讨自己是否真正了解那段经文的含义？
When we see doing something that's not according to the scriptures, would we ask God to go back to the frame that we've set for our sending towards Him, or we would reconsider and reevaluate our understanding towards God?
Consider our interpretation of the scripture. 我祷告。
My prayer is.
圣灵赐给我们谦卑的心。
The Holy Spirit give us a humble heart.
然后也亲自来帮助我们去明白神在每一个不同的季节里面的作为。
That God will personally come and help us to understand His works in different seasons.
以致我们不会错失他为我们预备的美好的计划。
That we will not miss out on the wonderful plans that He has prepared for us.
你想想，在那个时代的这些法利赛人，就是因为，没有办法认清神的作为，结果他们错失了与这一位道成肉身来到他们当中的神的那一个相遇。
Think of this, the Pharisees, because of their mindset, they're not able to meet and accept this God that has already come in flesh, that come into their midst.
Yep. 所以让我们在这个不同的季节里面继续保持一个敞开。跟谦卑的心，以致我们能够认出这是神的作为。
So in different seasons, ask God to help us to continue to come with a humble and open heart, that we're able to identify and see the work of God.
因为我们都渴慕要与他一同的前进。
Because all of us desire to move forward with Him.
第三点。
Third point.
我们在过去的季节所学习的一切是不会白费的。
What we learn in the previous seasons are not wasted.
在与尼哥德慕对话的下半段里面
，So in Jesus' second part of the conversation with Nicodemus，
然后耶稣引用了旧约圣经里面记载的一个事件。
So Jesus talked about something that was recorded in the Old Testament.
他用这个事件来解释神要怎样拯救世人。
He used this to explain how God is going to save the world.
在第十四节、十五节，耶稣这样说：摩西在旷野怎样把铜蛇举起，人子也必照样被举起来，使所有信他的人都得永生。
Verse 14 and 15, just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up.
这个事件其实记载在民数记第二十一章第四到第九节。
So this actually recorded in Numbers 21:4-9.
事情是这样的，那个时候以色列民在旷野里面向神发怨言。
So what happened was at the time the Israelites were complaining towards God.
他们说我们要回去埃及。
They said we want to go back to Egypt.
结果神就打发火蛇来咬他们。
So God put snakes of fire to beat them.
以色列民呢，就求摩西为他们代求。
So the Israelites asked Moses, they pleaded with Moses to intercede to God for them.
然后神就吩咐摩西打造一条的铜蛇，然后把它挂在那个一根杆上面。
So God asked Moses to build a bronze snake and then put on a rod.
被蛇咬的人只要望一下那个铜蛇，就得到医治，就可以活下来。
Those that have been bitten by the snakes, they only need to look at the bronze snake, and then they will be healed, and then they are able to survive.
耶稣接下来说，神就是要这样拯救世人的。
So Jesus said, in this way, the Son of Man, God is going to save the world.
所以他让自己的独生爱子变成人的样式，来到世上。被钉死在十字架上，为他们的罪付上代价。
He allowed his one and only son to come in the form of man to the earth, and then be crucified on the cross to pay the price of sin for all mankind.
凡是相信他的，就必得救。
Those that believe in him shall be saved.
尼哥德慕能够明白这个解释，为什么？因为他熟悉旧约的经文。
Nicodemus could understand this explanation. Why? Because he was familiar with the Old Testament.
他过去几十年来所领受的教导、所学习的经文，在这个时刻派上了用场。
So the teachings that he received from the past tens of years, at the time, it could be a help to him.
刚才我们所看到那一个电视剧里面的最后一个部分。
So just now in the last part of the TV series.
尼哥德慕向耶稣下跪，然后亲吻他的手。
Nicodemus knelt before Jesus and kissed his hand.
那一幕非常触动我的心。
That scene really touched my heart.
当然，圣经里面没有这样的记载。
Of course, this was not recorded in the Bible.
但是我觉得我们有理由相信尼哥德慕的确有可能这样子回应。
But there's reasons for us to believe that Nicodemus.Could possibly have responded in that way.
试想想，如果你是尼哥德慕，你在旧约圣经里面读到那么多关于弥赛亚的预言。
Think of this: if you were Nicodemus, you've read so much in the Old Testament regarding the Messiah that was to come.
然后，现在这位预言中所提到的弥赛亚就站在你的面前。
And then now, the Messiah that was prophesied is standing before you now.
你会没有反应吗
？Would you be numb and not responding.
尼哥德慕亲吻耶稣时的时候，他的时候，他所提的那个经文其实是在诗篇第二篇。
So the scripture that Nicodemus mentioned when he kissed the hand of Jesus was from Psalms chapter 2.
在第二篇第十二节。
Chapter 2 verse 12.
你们要用嘴亲吻子，否则他一发怒，你们就在路上灭亡。因为他的怒气快要发作，凡是投靠他的都是有福的。
Kiss his son, or he will be angry, and your way will lead you to your destruction. For his wrath can flare up in any moment. Blessed are all who take refuge in him.
看到这一幕，我真的非常的感动，眼泪都流出来了。
So when I saw this scene, I was very touched. Some tears even came up from my eyes.
这个是多么令人感动、激动的一个时刻。
That was such a touching moment.
Okay, 但是如果尼哥德摩没有把圣经 把诗篇里面这一个旧教导存在他的心里面的话，
So if Nicodemus did not have this old teaching from the Bible in him，
就他可能就没有办法分辨现在站在他面前的那一位全人类都在等待的这个弥赛亚就在他的面前。
Perhaps he could not understand and see that the Messiah that's waited for, that the whole mankind is waiting for, is just right before him.
Yeah, 所以我们在上一个季节所领受的教导，所领受的原则，有很多是对我们有益的。
So the teachings that we received from the previous seasons, a lot of them are beneficial for us.
Yeah, 就像耶稣在马太福音第十三章里面所提到的。
Just like what Jesus mentioned in Matthew 13.
第五十二节，耶稣说：“所以每一个做天国门徒的经学家，就像家主从宝库中拿出新和旧的东西来。”
Jesus said, "Therefore, every teacher of the law who has become a disciple in the kingdom of heaven is like the owner of a house who brings out of his storeroom new treasures as well as old."
这难道不是尼哥德慕吗？
Isn't this Nicodemus? Jesus was mentioning about.
宝库里面有新的宝物，也有旧的宝物。
So from the storeroom, there are old as well as new treasures.
无论是新的还是旧的，只要是放在宝所谓的宝库里面，因为那个地方叫宝库，你不既然是宝库，你不可能把垃圾放在里面，对吗
？So no matter is new or old treasures, this is something that's stored in the storeroom. You will not store something that's useless in the storeroom, right?
Okay, 所以有新的也有旧的，无论是新的还是旧的都是宝物。
So they are old and also new treasures, but no matter they are old or new, they are all treasures.
所以神在这个天国旅程里面所给我们的这些新的教导、新的相遇是宝物。
So these new encounters we have with Jesus, these new teachings, these new encounters are all treasures.
That we receive in this kingdom journey. Okay, 然后神在上一个季节里面所给我们的意象。
So the vision that God has given us in the previous seasons.
神在上一个季节里面所给我们的那些旧的教导也是宝物。
All teachings received from the previous seasons are also treasures.
Okay, 我们在这个新的季节里面领受的关于自由。尊荣、廉洁、身份，这些原则是宝物。
The principles that we receive in these new seasons, for example, freedom, honor, connection, identity, these are treasures.
我们在过去的那一个季节里面所领受的关于交代、关于顺服、关于委身、关于意向的教导跟原则也是宝物。
The principles we receive from the previous seasons, for example, accountability, commitment, vision, obedience, these are also treasures.
在耶利米书第六章第十六节
Jeremiah 6:16,
神这样说：你们要站在路上观察，寻访远古的路径，看哪一条是美善的路，就走在其中，这样你们心里就必得安息。
This is what the Lord says. Stand at the crossroad and look. Ask for the ancient paths. Ask where the good way is and walk in it. You will find rest for your souls. But you said, no. Yeah.
神要我们去寻访远古的路径。
God wants us to ask for ancient paths.
这就是我们在上一个季节里面所领受的、所学习的。
Which are the things we receive and receive.We learn and receive from the previous seasons.
因为在这个旧路当中，有一些东西是美善的。
Because in this ancient path, there are things that are good.
是神所喜悦的，他要我们行在其中。
There are things that are pleasing to God. He wants us to walk in it.
所以，让我们站在那个远古的路径上面。
So let us stand on the ancient paths.
然后尊荣我们在过去所领受的教导。
Honor the teachings that received in the past.
尊荣我们的领袖过去所立下的美好的根基。
Honor the good foundation that has been set by our leaders in the past.
但是同一个时候，我们带着渴慕的心，带着敞开的心。
But at the same time, we bring an eager heart, an open heart.
期待神在这个新的季节里面向我们显明更多他要做的心事。
Anticipate in these new seasons, God, the things, the many new things God is going to do in this new season.
Yeah. 所以我的总结在这篇信息里面三个原则。
So my conclusion in this today's sermon, the three principles.
面对挣扎不一定是坏事。
To face struggles is not surely a bad thing.
因为面对挣扎往往是一场属天相遇的开始。
Because struggles are often beginnings of divine encounter with God.
然后我们无法全然明白神的作为。
We are not able to fully understand the works of God.
但是我们却能够感受神作为的结果。
But we can recognize the effects.
好，最后我们在过去的季节所学习的一切不会是白费的。
Finally, what we learned in the previous seasons are not wasted.
我鼓励大家，我们一起来回应神。
So I encourage you to respond to God.
让我们向神来祷告。
Let's pray to God.
我祷告我们有像尼哥德慕这样的一颗谦卑的心。
I pray that we can be like Nicodemus to have a humble heart.
我想在这么多的在那个活在那个时代里面。他能够做出一个这样的决定来见耶稣，他的整个态度肯定有神非常喜悦的地方。
So, in living in the time that he was living in, but he made such a decision to go and meet Jesus, surely there's something pleasing to God in him.
他内心里面有那种的渴慕，有那种的不满足，他知道神要给他们更多。
He had this.Desire in his heart, he has this content in his heart. They knowing that it's more from God.
这样的一种的态度，这样的一种的谦卑，是我们在这一个天国之旅里面，我们必须要有的。
Such a kind of attitude is something we must have in this kingdom journey.
在同一个时候，让我们不要去鄙视我们在过去的在旧的季节里面我们所领受的。
But at the same time, let us not look down or despise the things we have learned or received in the old seasons.
像我刚才说的，尊荣过去，我们渴慕那更多在前面，在未来。
Honor the past, but also anticipate and look forward for the future.
在天国旅程里面，我们的心非常非常的重要，因为天国的事是关系到我们的心。
So in this kingdom journey, our heart is very important because it matters.
Kingdom matters, heart matters. Yeah, 天国的事是心事。
Kingdom matters, heart matters.
Yeah. 那我们来到神的面前，让神来带领我们。
Let's come before God to allow God to lead us.
那我们祈求圣灵赐给我们一个谦卑的心。
Let's ask Holy Spirit to give us a humble heart.
让他在我们里面也激起这种的。这一种的期待，这种的渴慕，这种的兴奋。
So ask Holy Spirit to raise in us such a desire, such excitement, such anticipation.
圣灵，我们需要你。
Oh, Holy Spirit, we need you.
我们需要你。
We need you.
求你来帮助我们。
You come and lead us.
在这个时刻就来触摸我们的心。
This moment, come touch our hearts.
我们也渴慕像尼哥德慕这样子，有一个这样的与你的面对面的一个相遇。
Desire to have a face-to-face encounter with you, just as this Nicodemus had.
我们不满足。
You're not satisfied.
我们知道今天我们所领受的、所经历的，也只是冰山一角，是一点点。
We know the things you experience, we learn is only the tip of the iceberg. It's only a bit.
在这个旅程里面，你为我们预备了好多好多好多的东西。
In this journey, you prepared so many things for us.
带领我们。
Lead us.
在我们的心里面激起。这一个渴慕，放下这个渴慕。
Stir up this desire in our hearts.
我们需要你。
We need you.
带领我们，帮助我们。
Lead us, help us.
我们需要更多的相遇。
We need more encounter.
我们渴慕更多的与你那面对面的那个时刻。
We desire more moments of face-to-face encounter with you.
是的，给我们更多。
Yes, Father, give us more.
给我们更多。
Give us more.
帮助我们。
Help us.
谢谢你。
Thank you, Lord.
就是我要为一些弟兄姐妹来祷告。
And pray for some brothers and sisters.
尤其是可能一些弟兄姐妹，你参与新山七万教会可能，蛮长的一段时间。
Perhaps you've for San Francisco, you joined Hope JV for a long period of time.
就你经历了两个季节。
You've been through two seasons.
可能你还有一些的懊悔，有一些的遗憾。你觉得可能在过去在旧的季节里面，那种的，你付出的，好像看起来好像白费，好像你没有看到结果，你有这种的一种的遗憾，这种的缺失在你的心里面。
Perhaps you might have regrets in you thinking that the previous sacrifices, the things you've done in the previous seasons, is in vain.
你觉得好像说过去付出的时间，做出的一些牺牲，一些好像你觉得浪费掉了。
Perhaps you feel that the efforts you put in, the time you've invested in the past, are wasted.
我相信神要鼓励你。
I believe God wants to encourage you.
像我们第三点提到的。
Like point three that we mentioned.
你在过去所领受的，所付出的。 是不会白费的。
The things we've offered up to God in the past, the things, the effort we put in, are not in vain.
圣灵，祷告这个时刻，你在这些弟兄姐妹的心里面来做这个工作。
Holy Spirit, we pray that at this moment you work in the hearts of the brothers and sisters.
放下这个决心。Put
in them this conviction.
是的，放下这个决心。Indeed,
put this conviction.
他们在主里所付出的、所领受的，是不会白费的。
All their effort in God are not wasted.
那远古的路径，他们站在其中的时候
，the ancient paths as they stand on it,
他们必得享神所为他们预备的那美好的应许。
They will enjoy the wonderful promises God has prepared for them.
哦，圣灵，你亲自在这些弟兄姐妹的身上来动工。
Lord, you may personally work in the hearts of these brothers and sisters.
是的，给他们一个记号。
Yes, give them a sign.
给他们一个记号。
Give them a sign.
现在这个时刻来触摸他们。
At this moment, touch them.
谢谢你。
Thank you, Lord.
谢谢你，天父，我们要感谢你，为着今天我们领受的。
Holy Father, we thank you for the things we received today.
是的。
Indeed.
我们期待前面更多。
We are more eagerly anticipating the future.
我们要欢庆前面你要给我们的那更多的相遇。
We celebrate the many more encounters that we will encounter with you in the future.
一切荣耀颂赞都归给你。
Our glory and honor be upon you.
奉耶稣基督圣名我们祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Okay, 神赐福大家。
God bless you.
I've been strong and I've been broken with the inner moment. I've been faithful and I've been reckless in every bend. I've held everything together and watched it shatter. I've stood tall and I have crumbled in the same breath. I have wrestled and I have trembled towards surrender. Chase my heart of drifting, drifted home again. Plundered blessing till I've been desperate to find redemption. And every time I turn around, though, you're still there. Somebody you still want. So.
faithful and you are gracious, and I'm just grateful.